Hi, you're watching Dante's Boxing Nation. Woo! Hey.
Dante's Boxing Nation, what's going on, guys? You know, stories like this are stories that usually you would only hear from new media. So I was a little taken back and surprised, but at the same time, happy to see that even some of the old media, some of the mainstream media writers have even addressed this issue with ESPN. When it comes to the double standards and the overt favoritism they show towards the fighters that they like personally. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get into the actual story. Now, if you guys didn't listen to the ESPN broadcast during the Tyson Fury versus Otto Weiland fight, Tyson Fury, he was cut in the third round. Now, Tyson Fury and his team, they thought that it was a cut caused by headbutt. Matter of fact, Tyson Fury, he went back to his corner. His corner said, don't worry, it was a headbutt. And Tyson, he replied with the question, so it was a headbutt. And they said, yes. Now, when ESPN's Joe Tessitore, when he found out that Tyson Fury thought that it was a headbutt, all of a sudden he desperately urged Bernardo Usana to go over to Tyson Fury's corner and ask them if they were aware that the cut was caused by a punch. So Bernardo, he follows his orders. He goes over there and he asks them and he tells them it was caused by a punch. It wasn't caused by a headbutt. In other words, ESPN, they give Tyson Fury the heads up. Now, just to give you guys a better example of what ESPN just actually did in this situation, you know, when it comes to Olympic boxing, before they used to go on a point system where every punch that was landed is counted as a point. You score, right? So you land a jab, that counts as a point, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. But it's not open scoring to the fighters. They don't know what the score is until the end of the fight. Now imagine if someone ran over to one of the fighter's corners when he wasn't supposed to, and he whispered to them, hey, you guys are down by 10 points. You need to hurry up and pick it up. This is basically what Joe Tessitore and Bernardo Usana did in the Tyson Fury fight. Their conflict of interest, their intervention could have possibly changed the result in this fight. ESPN understood that if that fight would have got stopped, it would have been considered a TKO loss for their fighter, Tyson Fury. So clearly, Joe Tessitore, for a moment, he forgot that he was a blow-by-blow announcer, and he did whatever it took to try to save Tyson Fury from losing that fight by TKO. The act was so biased that even BoxingScene.com, one of the biggest mainstream boxing websites, they even reported on it and acknowledged that it was an extreme bias conflict of interest by Joe Tessitore and ESPN. They even said more members of the media should be talking about this. Now, before I go even deeper into this situation, I wanted to show you guys something. Did you guys know that if you Google ESPN and you go to Wikipedia, this is what they will tell you about ESPN? Quote, while ESPN is one of the most successful sports networks, there has been much criticism of ESPN, which includes accusations of biased coverage, conflict of interest, and controversies with individual broadcasters and analysts. End quote. Now guys, this is Wikipedia saying this about ESPN. How many of you guys knew about this? I mean, how often do you hear about Wikipedia describing someone, some network, as being biased? I mean, it's one thing when a fan is calling you biased, but when Wikipedia includes those words, bias and conflict of interest, in their description of ESPN, wow, that is amazing to me. I mean, I can go real deep onto how each and every one of these guys, from Max Kellerman to Dan Raphael to even Bernardo Usana, Joe Tessitore, are extremely biased. And it doesn't always have to be fighters that even fight for ESPN. Sometimes they even go out of their way to defend a fighter who's on that hope list. Like I said, we already know about Dan Raphael. But even when it comes to Bernardo Usana, who usually flies low under the radar, but the more they give him an opportunity to do blow-by-blow announcing on ESPN, the more he's starting to come out of the closet, if you know what I mean. Matter of fact, I remember when he was calling the Anthony Yard. He was calling the Kovalev versus Anthony Yard fight. And he said something that I thought was pretty disrespectful to Andre Ward. It was clearly a hit and dig at Andre Ward, trying to discredit his win against Kovalev. Andre Ward, who was doing his job, and he was saying as he was watching the Kovalev versus Yard fight, that Sergey Kovalev does not like it to the body. For those of you who know, Andre Ward, he fought Kovalev twice. He should know. He hurt Kovalev with body shots. That's how he ended up winning that fight when he made it an inside fight. I've been telling you guys for a long time, Kovalev, he cannot fight on the inside. He is very weak when it comes to the body, and that's why I believe Canelo is going to knock out Kovalev easily. I don't even believe that fight will be that competitive, but that's another video. That's for another video. So, once again, Andre Ward, he says this. He says Sergey Kovalev does not like it to the body. And Bernardo, he calls himself countering what Andre Ward said by saying, yeah, he also doesn't like it when fighters put his head down and hits him. So he's trying to defend Sergey Kovalev while at the same time taking credit away from the man that's sitting right next to him, working with him, Andre Ward. Now, I would expect that from some ignorant internet trolling fan just posting comments on the internet, but I wouldn't expect someone like Bernard to say that, especially when he's actually working with Andre Ward. That was extremely disrespectful to Andre Ward, what he said. By him saying that on air, you already know what he says to his friends and colleagues off air about Andre Ward's fight against Kovalev. Now, he done said other things about fighters on the coincidentalist as well in the past, but I'm just giving you an example of what we're looking at, what we're dealing with even a person who kind of flies under the radar. But this is what we're dealing with ESPN. Once again, like I've always said, Dan Raphael, who is an American reporter, he doesn't fly. And keep in mind, he gets paid to fly to these states and countries to cover these fights. Before Andre Ward fought Sergey Kovalev, Dan Raphael did not fly to California to cover his fellow countryman, Andre Ward, against Sullivan Barrera, the undefeated number one contender, Sullivan Barrera. But yet Dan Raphael, he went all the way across the globe to cover Golovkin versus Kell Brook. Oh, but when Errol Spence went to the UK to fight against Kell Brook, Dan Raphael didn't go to the UK to watch that fight and cover it. Now, I'm just giving you guys a sample, but there are tons of examples when it comes to Dan Raphael, when it comes to the racial double standards. I mean, if I broke it all down to you, this video would be damn near 2 hours. So let's just move on for now. You got Max Kellerman, who was saying that Manny Pacquiao was great than Mayweather immediately right after Mayweather had beat him. And then more recently, Max Kellerman started to say that Manny Pacquiao is the greatest fighter of all time. Coincidentally, right after he said that, BoxRec, they came out and they announced Floyd Mayweather is the greatest fighter of all time, which I know that really had to piss Max Kellerman off. But this is the pattern that we see with ESPN. This is the pattern that we see. ESPN, they kept saying they wanted to see Mayweather versus Manny Pacquiao. All the way up until the announcement, they were saying they wanted to see the fight. Soon as Floyd Mayweather beat Manny Pacquiao in what was considered the fight of the century, Floyd Mayweather wins the fight, and ESPN, who do they give the Fighter of the Year award to? Ronda Rousey. Ironically enough, Ronda Rousey, she would end up getting knocked out the same year they gave her that award. So at the end of the day, it's good that we're talking about this. It's good that mainstream boxing websites are reporting on this. The favoritism and the racial double standards need to cease when it comes to ESPN. I'm gonna talk a lot more about this, but I need to shorten this video because I was planning on really going in deep, but we'll do a part on this. That's all I got for now, guys. I'm on to the next one.